The Pack and Go wizard can be used to compress and save the publication to external storage devices. It can include linked files, such as another publication, or an Excel worksheet with the publication. The Pack and Go wizard can also save the files to a folder on the hard drive for copying. Also, TrueType fonts can be embedded into the publication, which will ensure that the proper fonts are used with the publication when it's brought to another computer that may not have the same fonts in its font bank. A zip file will be created along with the compressed publication with a packing list of the packaged files. To use the Pack and Go wizard, ensure you have the Pack and Go wizard file open. Then, click the File menu. Select Pack and Go. Then, select the Take to a Commercial Printing Service option. In the event that it has a couple of things for you to fix before it can be distributed and packaged, make the necessary changes in the Task pane. Then, select the Save button. In the Pack and Go dialog box, select the Other Location Radio button. Select the Browse button. Choose a destination to create a folder. I'm going to place the files on the desktop. Then, to create a new folder, select the New Folder button. Type a name for your folder. Then, select the OK button to create it. It will automatically open to that newly created folder to be the destination point for your files. So, select the OK button once again. Once back in the Pack and Go Wizard dialog box, select the Next button. Publisher will process your requests, and once successfully packed, it will alert you with a new dialog box. In this dialog box, deselect the Print a Composite Proof checkbox. Then, select the OK button. The folder and compressed files will be found in the destination that you selected. For us, it's the desktop. So, to unpack the files, navigate to that location that contains your package publisher files. Once you've navigated to that folder, double-click on it to open and view the contents. For this instance, mine is the printing folder located on my desktop. Once you're inside of the folder that has the contents, double-click on the WinZip icon. Once the WinZip window opens, ensure that you have the publisher file selected. Then, click the Extract button. In the Extract dialog box, specify a location to extract the files to. Click the Extract button. You can now close all of your open windows and dialog boxes. Locate and double-click on the publication file. In the Load Fonts dialog box, take a look at which fonts are and are not available. Then, choose the relevant options and click the OK button. Your file should load as normal, in which now you can print or continue working on your project.